1. Google AdSense. Google AdSense might be the fastest and easiest way for a beginner to start earning passive income with a blog. The basic idea behind AdSense is that you can display Google ads on your website, and when a visitor clicks on those ads, you get a percentage of the ad costs. You've certainly seen ads on other people's websites. You can have these ads appear on your blog or website as well. AdSense is a contextual advertising network that places partner business ads on your website. It's easy to set up. All you have to do is copy and paste some code given to you from Google in the places you'd like the ads to appear on your website. Google will then show ads from advertisers that are a match to the content on your website, so that ideally your website visitors see relevant ads. 2. Amazon Associates. Amazon Associates is the long-established in-house affiliate program run by Seattle-based Amazon.com, the biggest online retailer in the world today. It offers bloggers the chance to earn commissions by advertising Amazon products on your website, provided visitors click through from your blog to Amazon.com and make a purchase. The basic idea with Amazon Associates is that you can get a tracking link that is unique to you that links to any product sold on Amazon.com. If someone clicks on the link on your blog and goes back to Amazon and purchases the item, you are credited with the sale. 3. Create ebooks and information products. Regular blogging is the ideal training ground for creating ebooks, still one of the most popular forms of information products being sold by online entrepreneurs today. Consider your blogs as free information that you offer to readers to demonstrate your expertise. With time, they become your fans and are ready for more in-depth material. This is your opportunity to make money by presenting your ebooks for sale alongside your free blog. Just make sure that the ebook builds on your blog output. Don't simply rehash what they have already seen. After all, these people are now paying customers and will get upset with old information. Later on, as you become more established and your archived material becomes more extensive, you can poll your readers to learn what topics they'd be interested in learning more about and interested in purchasing.